FortuneBuilders.tv. Killer real estate secrets. A&E TV stars. Number one educational company. National speakers. Hands-on trainers. FortuneBuilders.tv.
Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of FortuneBuilders.tv. That's right, you got your old pal JD Asajan in the hot seat today, and this is where we bring the real estate education to you. And I'm happy to be here on another episode. Fun topic today, something that I get asked quite a bit, and specifically we're going to be focusing on high-end or luxury renovation properties, because one of the questions I've been getting asked lately from our students is and other investors is, should I get into high-end renovations? I hear about the ability to be able to make more profits in these deals, and what's your opinion of that, JD? Well, I've got a lot of opinions about a lot of things, and when it comes to higher-end renovations, I can certainly give everyone some insight. Let's talk for a little bit about the idea of being a jack of all trades and a master of none, right? You hear that concept before. A lot of people, when they get started in real estate, they hear a lot of different things. Oh, well, I hear the market's better in this area. Luxury high-end renovations, man, there's a lot of money to be made there. Understand that if you don't focus and get good on one thing, then you're gonna be scattered all over the place. If you wanna try to buy REOs, then you start to try to do short sales, then you look at doing high-end renovations, you start talking about loan modifications. Before you know it, you're doing a little bit of everything and you're not really good at anything. So first off, my suggestion is to get good at one thing, and really starting out, that should be single family residential redevelopment, buying, fixing, and selling the most resilient part of the market, and that's single family homes in medium price points, okay? Because those are the areas that are buying and selling quickly in this market, right? Three bedroom, two bath, 1200 square feet, cookie cutter neighborhoods, everything that a buyer wants, first time home buyer homes, right? So that's my first comment to that. But when you get good at that and you're ready to tackle some of these higher end projects, there is a lot of money to be made. But understand there's also a lot of money to lose, because with more risk comes more reward, but there's also more opportunity for losing a lot of money. Because understand, when you buy a higher end home that's outside of the norm for your area, and you have to sell that at a higher price because it has more amenities and it can command more of a price, what you really are doing is you're narrowing the buying population. So if you've got first-time home buyers, there's thousands of them that can buy that medium price point house or that beginner price point property. When you jump up into that next level of higher-end homes, one of the things you're doing is you're narrowing down the amount of people that can actually afford that property. And that can be good and bad. Certainly bad in the standpoint that there's gonna be less people that can qualify. Good in that the people that can qualify are probably gonna be very qualified. They're not gonna be tire kickers. They're gonna be truly financially available and able to buy that house. They're gonna have the down payment. They're not an FHA buyer. They're a conventional buyer that needs at least 20% down. And they're gonna be looking at a price point that they can truly afford. So that's a good thing. But also understand that they're gonna want everything. Okay, they're not gonna be okay with laminate floors. They're gonna want everything because it's not their first home, it's their move-up home, it's probably their dream home. So those are things to consider when you're looking at getting into that higher-end luxury renovation market. Now let me tell you what, we've done a lot of higher-end homes and made a lot of money, and that's great, and you can do the same too, but until you get good at that first-time home buyer market, I would tell you not to get into the luxury market. Because again, I mentioned that everything costs more when you get into that space because houses are bigger, the finishings are different, and you need to get good at stamping out your first-time homebuyer property first, okay? So that's my overall concept when it comes to luxury renovations and buying and selling in that space. What I'd like to talk about next is, in fact, our deal or no deal segment.
Deal or no deal.
One of the things that I like to do in the deal or no deal segment is actually break down a property that we've looked at recently. And lo and behold, I have one right here. Okay? This is a property in East County, San Diego, which is where we're buying and selling a lot of real estate now. And this is a higher end home. This is a property that was, that we bought actually for $460,000. That's right, $460,000 before the house is even being renovated. Okay, now let's talk about what makes that a deal or not a deal. Well, you heard that we bought it, so you can assume that it probably was a deal. But let's talk about what we looked at. So we run the numbers the same way we do, just as we do any property, our big three numbers. What's the ARV? What are the repair costs? And what are we gonna offer, right? This property was not listed. We're actually dealing directly with the seller. And when you're doing that, you have the ability to do a lot more negotiations. But we analyzed it the same way we do any property. We pulled comps in that area of similar type properties, which there aren't a lot of. It's a 5,500 square foot estate on 8 acres with a swimming pool, a tennis court, amazing westerly views, a lot of really cool features about this property. But we analyzed it, determined that the ARV of this property was in the mid to upper eights. All right, $800,000. Let's call it $850,000. But what we do is we want to be conservative, because remember I mentioned that there's less buyers in that higher price point. So we actually estimated that we'd want to list the property at a very, very affordable price for that style of home, which we were estimating $799 to be able to list this property. And we work backwards from there. Our repair costs on this particular home were about $100,000. And when you run the numbers, get backwards to your offer price, you want to buy a house like that in the fours, in the $400,000 range, medium $400,000 range, and that's going to put you in a position, if you run the numbers on this particular property, to make six figures in net profit on this deal. And that's really what you want to be looking at in higher end luxury renovations. And so in this particular case, the things that are important to note are that we're comparing it to other properties in that area. And we're also, once we know what's selling in that area, we want to put a conservative price, sales price on that property when we're done. The idea, no matter what range you're in, whether it be first time home buyer or luxury homes, you want to have the best product available, meaning that it's the nicest house someone can find in that area at the best price. And when you have the best product at the best price, that's how you move properties quickly. All right, so in this particular case, our East County 5,500 square foot hilltop estate was a deal.
Deal.
And a good deal at that. And let me tell you, we're gonna go on site on one of the upcoming episodes and take you through that property, okay? So let's talk next about our question and answer segment, our real estate quick tip.
Questions and answers.
Okay, now I want to get into our question and answer segment of the show, our real estate quick tip segment, okay? And we're going to be talking about higher end homes, because that's been the focus of today's show. One of the questions I got asked recently at an event was, what should I look for in luxury high-end renovations? And I talked about some of it earlier, and really you want to look at what else is selling in that market. This is how you answer that question. What else is selling in that market, in that price point, similar type properties? And then you want to have some of those same features. You also want to have some features that the other properties don't have, because when you're dealing in that luxury market, people want something unique. They want something different, and they're willing to pay for it. So what does that mean? Well, it usually means some form of a view. Houses with views are absolutely spectacular. People want to live there. They want to be in a place where they can look outside their window, get onto their deck, have a dinner at sunset, and be able to look at something other than their neighbor's backyard. Right? That's important. So views are very important. Having other amenities that are unique to that home, things like access to a golf course, if they're on a golf course, tennis courts, swimming pools, spas. Those are the things that are important to people than when they spend a lot of money on a luxury home. Enough parking spaces to be able to accommodate their multiple vehicles. Many times, if there's a separate area or garage for the homeowner to be able to park their luxury automobiles, because if someone can afford to spend that much money on a home, they probably have more than one car. So thinking about the end user, just like you would in a first-time home buyer, single-family property, same thing. But that particular buyer in the higher-end home wants different things. So those are some of the things that you want to look for and think about when you're looking at higher-end homes, and being able to give that buyer something that's special and unique in a good affordable price point, even for that market. And that's how you will have more success in that market. All right, very important things to think about.
Quote of the week.
The last thing I want to do is go over our quote of the week. I always like to leave everyone with some thoughts and some things to think about. One of the things that my brother Paul and I have talked about for years, since we started the company years ago, and one of the quotes that really resonated with us, is the one I want to share with you today. How you do anything is how you do everything. Think about that for a moment and what that means to you in your personal life and in your professional life, because it's really important. How you do each little thing in your life is really how you do everything. And it's important that you do that in every area of your life. People will notice that, and when you're proud about what you do and you carry yourself the right way in every little task that you take on, it shows, and it's important. So how you do anything is how you do everything. It's been said by a lot of people. There's books with that title. Think about that, what that means to you, and look forward to seeing everyone on the next episode.
FortuneBuilders.tv